Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Kolonization series in Kerbal Space Program 0.24.2. In this episode, I hope to first remedy some of the issues I had with the previous episode, successfully delivering a tanker to the moon, as well as delivering a replacement orange. But here you can see this is a super orange, with the thrusters now on these extendable struts. And I chose these AES structural beams because not only are they fuel crossfeed capable, of course, otherwise I would have to run fuel lines, but also they're much lighter than anything else. You can see that these beams are 0.005 mass compared to the much more, hefty versions that come stock. So definitely want to use those. And in fact, they're even lighter than the, what you got, pistons that come with the Magic Smoke Industries Infernal Robotics Pack. So might as well use these instead. Where were those? Ah, there we go. Hydraulic cylinders, for instance, 0.2 would have been much heavier. I've added some more solar panelry to the orange, as you can see. Otherwise, no significant changes. So yeah, I also added a remote controller in the place of a fuel tank. I had an Oscar B there, but I dumped it, instead put one of the Probodobodyne Octos. So that'll be a good idea, hopefully. So again, this is to extend these thrusters away from the body of the tanker so that the tanker doesn't get in the way of them. Hopefully that really was the issue last time with the orange and that there isn't any other problems. I've done a test fire of these rockets just to make sure that they can fire on these things, but I haven't done any other testing. So just a test fire of that static on the launch pad. Okay, so this is on the Yakko, and this is not the only thing we're going to launch at the moon this time. We are also going to launch a new carbonite miner that's a little bit more robust than my previous one. So that'll be good, and so we can start serious carbonite mining operations and bring it back to the station, and we'll have a distillery and all the basic functions on the station so that the station can convert the carbonite to something useful. Okay, so that's all planned, and yeah, I think we need to get this staged properly, but otherwise we look to be good to go. The orange will have a lot to do today. We'll see if it's up to the task. So super orange underway. Okay, so full disclosure, I did have to revert in order to kick Jeb out of the cockpit, but otherwise we are good to go now. All systems nominal. All right, off we go. So somebody had asked basically what other destinations I'm planning to colonize. And of course the moon is sort of a test run as far as I'm concerned. We're sort of testing all of our systems to see if they'll work, and then we can move on to bigger and better targets. The next target is probably Val or Duna. I mean, we'll take a look at... the first thing I want would be somewhere where the gravity is approximately the same as the moon. Val's about the same, Duna's about the same, and so those would be logical places to start colonizing. And then we'd have to adapt our systems for somewhere like Lathe. Of course, along the way we have to figure out how to get funds. That is still a thing here. Ooh, I'm taking a little bit of time to make my adjustments. That's not good. Too cut up on talking, forgetting that I've got a lot of thrust here. Yay, fairing separation. That's not working out quite well in realism overhaul right now. Okay, pretty sloppy for me. I must be out of it today. That happens. I seem to have forgotten to add a SAS unit up here. And the reaction control units on these aren't good enough to turn this sort of thing around. Okay, well, it looks like that stage did not get us all the way there. That's fine, the orange can take it. But we have to do this carefully now. Yes, indeed. So let's decouple. See now. I guess we'll go with the orange in this orientation. Let's see. Okay, control from here. Let's get the this way. Okay, got some light. Right. Okay, that looks like they're all the way out. Now, what I don't know, since it was a launch pad test and it was all clamped down, I don't know if there's got to be any spin. There might be. Okay, well, let's turn around. And continue this burn. After doing that. Oh, there is spin. Darn. Well, we can spin for now. That is annoying. So this is a super spinning orange. That's not gonna be very helpful. We do have RCS on it, so we'll see how much that can counteract this spin. Maybe Smart ASS can do a better job? We'll see. No, Smart ASS seems to be able to hold it steady. Won't help much on the landing, though. Okay, accidental and unnecessary free return trajectory confirmed. Alright. So let's get into better light and then I can redock this properly. Because right now obviously this is not the configuration for landing this thing. I'm still going to try and land the tanker. I just have to be a little bit more careful about it. Okay, here we go. Stack separators done his thing. And I'm going to switch to this. Going to use its... Should have its own little reaction wheel control, doesn't it? Oh no, this is the stack separator I'm on. No wonders. Okay, there we go. And I want to target this. Control from here. There we go. There it is. Okay. And no, that doesn't seem to be right, is it? No, no. No, I would not expect it to be there. More like there. Okay, well, I'll go with my own instinct on this one, I think. Oh god, what happens if a stack separator gets in the middle of the docking? I'm waiting with morbid curiosity to find out. I wonder what happened to it. Is it sandwiched in there or not? Now, here's a more troubling question. I didn't think I would be using that much liquid fuel doing that tiny little burn. Still says we have quite a lot of fuel left. A lot of Delta V left. But I got tricked on the way down. I thought that it was because the tanker was in the way, but what if it wasn't because the tanker was in the way? What if my Delta V calculation in this case is incorrect somehow? That's what I'm worried about here. But anyway, we will proceed. To the moon! Okay, so I've gone ahead and plotted my orbit and my descent. Let's see how this all works out. Trying once again to deliver a tanker to our base on the moon. Okay, the electric charge is worrying me a little bit. Let me tilt towards the sun for a while until we get to our maneuver node. Gonna have Smart ESS hold node so that we don't roll. Sort of. I'll keep it to half. And I'm expecting to see no less than 2,400 at the end of this burn. Incidentally, even at half thrust, we have enough thrust to make a landing on the moon. And that's because this thing is supposed to carry loads of up to 10 tons. The tanker is only about 3 tons. Which debris is that? Don't tell me the launcher actually managed to come all the way out here. Or is that the little stack separator that managed to wander away? No idea. Anyway, I've been warned not to switch to other vessels when I'm away from the tracking station. It might cause glitching, so I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to leave that little bit of debris a mystery. Need that. Okay, that one's done. Next, let's go to that node. And so there's the initial descent. And it looks like our path is like that. Yep, looks good, except perhaps a little bit closer than I had intended. So we will, whoa, that was not very precise at all. There, that's a little bit better. Yeah. Gotta make sure to clear any sort of obstruction on the way. Okay. Still gotta worry about the spinning thing, but by the time we're doing a touchdown, we shouldn't be using too much throttle, so that's the plus side. Gonna change the camera view now. Also, the payload is sort of askew. I wonder if that causes a problem too. Possibly. But it is working out a little bit better than previously. Let's get closer. Oh, wow, it's really deviating. Eventually we'll use RCS to control this, but no point using it right now, I think. Let's see, I think I can just program this one in. How are we? Pretty much right in line. So let's go 68 on it. Ah, I see. We seem to be in this sort of depression here. It's clearer now. Wasn't so clear in the dark. Orbit retrograde is not surface retrograde. Okay. Let's hold off on that idea. Looks like I'll just have to take it from here. And I'll be using RCS to keep this. Come on, RCS. You can do it. Or not. Okay. Wow, RCS is not helping much at all. Uh-oh, lag is not good. Lag is not good. Stop lagging. That's not right. I'm getting lag all over the place now. That's not right at all. That's better. Okay, now I'm gonna have to mimic a program landing, which means like that. Without RCS, thank you very much. Could use 315.89. 270.88. Good. I need to develop some sort of tolerance level for surface horizontal speed. Let's see how 0.2 meters per second works out. I hope that's okay. Now let's pass my tolerance now. I can deal with that just by slowing down, I think. Or not. Okay. 315.88, I think, will do. Program 90. Execute 90. Zero, 315. Okay. Uh-oh. Okay, there we go. That was not good for a while. Okay. Alright, that's enough of that. Stop that. Okay, heading 90 pitch. Let's say 30. Okay, UI glitching. Because I switched vessels, of course, had to. Should have remembered to control from here, but alright. Fortunately, MechJeb is not affected, and in that case, I still have my displays. But we won't know until we switch back to the tanker whether this whole thing worked out. Okay, that's good enough. The spinning is going to be annoying, but hey. Now we should flip this around so that it gets some sun. I don't know if... let's see. Should just go radial on it. Let's go like this. That'll be best. And how much delta V do we have left? Ah, plenty. Okay, good. Now, back to our tanker, and I'm gonna switch using the tracking. Okay, KSP actually crashed after I tried to go to the tracking station, but look! I've confirmed that our Super Orange is in orbit. I haven't renamed it yet, though. Need to do that, otherwise it's not going to be very distinct, but where are you? There it is. So that's the Super Orange. But yeah, but we got our tanker to the surface. Let's drive it over to the emergency hab. We've got 305 meters, that's not too far away. So doesn't really make very tight turns. Probably a good thing, actually. Oops, skidding. Okay, let's not go too fast. The moon doesn't really provide much traction, even for something heavy like this. I have no idea whether this can actually turn the emergency hab upright, whether it has traction or not. I deliberately tried to make it a heavy vehicle in, so that it had the mass to have the downforce. Not too sure it does, though. But yeah, first I'm going to evacuate the Kerbals outside of the emergency hab before trying to pull the emergency hab upright. I think this will be our main activity. We'll see. I don't know if I'm gonna have the time to do the Karbonite miner launch in this episode. Okay, let's set the brakes here. Time to get the Kerbals out. This is the Pack Rat Rover. Other stuff that we don't need. Ah, that's the original miner. And the emergency hab. Or not? Yes, it is. Okay, of course I switched vessels, so I'm gonna get UI glitching. We will take that to be expected. Now, first thing, I think this was Jorvi or was it Deseric? Whatever, faceplant, come on. I need him to get a an attachment point so that we can slap that onto the emergency hab so that we can winch it up. Can okay, we can open container. Radial connector port. I want to take one. Close. Okay, you can see he's got the radial connector port on his back there. Okay. Trying our best not to glitch into things. Let's put the... No, I want you to face... What the heck are you doing? It's like he's... Okay, I want you... Okay. I think I can just use the mouse button. Okay, nice little sound effect there. Okay. His job is done. Okay, jump forward. There we go. Okay, that was the wrong way. Sorry. Okay. Clear off to the side. We'll have you guys meet by the flag. Go through all the vehicles. There we go. Okay, so that was Jorvi Kerman who did that. Now Desrick does the other part, which is actually making the attachment. Face plant. Uh-oh. Don't glitch. Uh-oh. What? Okay, so game crashed again. Looks like Jorvi is present near the flag, but is Desrick in the emergency hab? That's the question. Yes, he is. Okay, so he's safe. Okay, good. All right, let's try this one more time. And it is switching vessels, apparently, that does this. Let's use the jetpack this time. Yeah, come on. Okay, up. But there we go. All right. So now, not close enough. Okay. Grab connector. Okay. Now let's see. Okay. All right, everybody get clear now. Oh no. He glitched into that thing. Ah, I didn't want that to happen. Okay, good. Got the jetpack going. Good. Okay, by the flag, please. Bad landing. I don't know if the tanker is going to have enough torque for this. We'll see. It's already sort of tilting badly. Okay. Uh-oh. No, put brakes. Uh-oh. This seems like trouble. Shoot, it looks like we're front wheel drive. we do have some tiny bit of torque on this, but it ain't much. And we seem to be controlled backwards. That's probably the way I... Okay, now we've got it. Make sure that's not messing around with anything. Okay, now that's fallen off. Please tell me that this will allow this tanker to upright itself. I'm gonna get so much glitching. I'm probably inches away from... Come on. Why is it so back heavy? I had the fuel tank up front. Maybe not having that up front has made a... Maybe adding some carbonite up front would help. Why is it still being pulled back? This is weird. Okay, retract. Come on. Huh. Interesting. So while it's extended, this... Oh, well, no. There goes that theory. This thing... This tanker is a little bit messed up. Worked perfectly fine on Kerbin. Crud. I think we need a Kerbal for this. Right. You think you could figure this out? Kerbals, of course, masters of ingenuity when it comes to all these sorts of devices. I was sort of hoping just him jumping up and down on this might knock it down. Let's see. Nope. And apparently this is not how you enter this pod. It always wants to pull back onto the... well, that's probably the slope. Yeah, that's probably the slope of the crater. Show GUI. Come on, you want to do it? Ah, crud. Oh, wow. Let's see, maybe if we fill these carbonite tanks somehow, then we could do it. But that's a little bit of a trick. We need one of those little carry cans. The Jorby's gonna get knocked. Okay, who stopped? Oh, no, he's actually in front of it. Okay. This is all messed up. Okay, close this thing. Parking brakes. No. Well, maybe. Let's see. This is going to be touchy. Actually, let's get our Kerbal out of the way. Sort of. No, it's stepping back again. Let's extend. Now retract. Okay, release. There we go. Brakes. And retract. Okay, well, this is not ideal. Don't snap. There we go. Okay. Huh. Well, that's interesting. I might have to think about how exactly I want to go about this. At least we recovered this so that it won't be tipped over the whole time. But clearly it cannot do the thing that I wanted it to do most. That doesn't mean it's not useful. It's got plenty of supplies. It's got a lot of opportunity to help us out here. It's just that when the winch is extended, it doesn't... Maybe if we get a long distance? I don't know how far away we can get. The problem is this huge slope, actually. Yeah, I mean, it's really... The fact that this is such a slope is a big problem. Or it might be okay. If we are high enough... I don't know. Seems like it might still be a problem. I wonder how far this winch can extend. Let me just quickly make sure that we're not pulling that into some weird location. Okay, well, all the way over here. There we go. Okay, well, if I tip it over again, it's gonna be bad, but okay, plug undock. Come on. Yeah. Still gonna do that. Let's see if leverage helps. Let's get the Kerbal out of the way. That's why I didn't immediately switch back, of course, because got the Kerbal here. I don't know. What do you think? Can you do this? Doesn't really look like it. I wonder what would happen if I have you guys dock together. Well, what can I say? We need something different, probably. I'm not saying this thing won't eventually be a useful unit, but right now it did not do what I wanted it to do. Let's get the Kerbals back safe into their hab. Such as it is, even though it's tipped over, it still works, so... I guess we could try winching up the orange at some point. But we should get some fuel to it, too. There's no point winching up the orange if there's no fuel. Okay, well, Kerbal's safely back into the hab, such as it is. And, well, we delivered the tanker truck successfully. We tested the new orange, found that it rolled, it spun around a little bit, but I was able to land it thanks to Smart ASS. And really, that was the first time you've seen me do a... Smart ASS, somewhat automated landing on the moon, which is a little bit trickier than doing it by hand, of course. Needs a little bit more quick thinking, but anyway, we've done something, and I'm going to try and come up with a better system. I do have the Karbonite miner already lined up for the next episode, so we'll see about that. If you have any comments, suggestions, especially about what I should be doing next, try and keep it within my my capabilities right now, which are admittedly limited. We need to build up some more funds before I really start building up the base, but I think that has to happen. I wanted to do that in this episode, but then I was also thinking about this and the orange and the fact that I'd failed with the tankers, so I decided to opt for this mission instead. I was aiming to build up the real base instead of the emergency hab, and I think we're just going to have to leave this emergency hab like this now. I really do want to tip it upright properly, but for now it's servicing it. It's serviceable. It is functional. So we'll just leave it be. And we will continue and build our real one, probably looking for a flatter surface. I think one thing I'll have the guys do, the Kerbals, is hop into either the pack rat or the tanker and hunt for flatter locations and then mark that with either the pack rat or the tanker so that we can build a base there. All right. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time.